Rational Team Concert version 4.0 presents packaging and deploying with Enterprise Extensions. The Enterprise Extensions packaging and deployment features allow you to package build outputs and deploy the outputs to runtime environments on other systems. During the packaging step, artifacts on the build system are archived as deployable packages. We will open this package definition to see how it has been defined. On the Overview tab, select the build engine that was used to run the packaging build on the build system. The build definition is selected to help determine what built objects will be packaged. The package root directory indicates where the package will be created. The ship list is generated from the list of files that you add to the include and exclude tables. On the ZOS Packaging Options tab, specify the required publishing options and the optional mapping information. Next, we will create a package. There are two packaging options. One option selects the package artifacts using work items, and the other uses a ship list. If we use ship list packaging, we have to specify the list of artifacts that we want to ship. The next three pages of the packaging wizard allow us to override the package definition. Any changes we make here will only affect the current package that we are creating. Use the builds view to monitor the progress of the packaging request. The files listed on the Download tab are determined by the options that are selected in the package definition. The Package Summary tab shows all the output objects that have been packaged. A summary work item that lists information about the package is automatically created. The summary work item has a links tab that lists links to the package artifacts, including the packaging result. We have created a change set that is ready to be delivered. View the code change in the compare editor. Once the change set is delivered, run a build to generate the output objects. This time, we will request a work item package. After we select work item packaging, we choose the work items that we want to package. In this example, we run a query to choose the work items. We can expand and view all our work items, including the children and associated outputs. Again, the next three pages of the packaging wizard allow us to override and customize the package definition. For this example, we will customize the include ship list. Note that we can modify the ship list even though we are using work item packaging. In the ship list manager, we will search for specific members by running a query using dataset and member filters and then selecting the specific members from the query results. The Package Summary tab lists all the output objects that have been packaged and the associated work items. The summary work item lists the work items that were packaged. To see details about packages that have already been created, from the context menu on the package definition, select Show All Packages. You can navigate to the details from the resulting list of packages. During the deployment step, packages are transferred from the build system to the deployment system, and the package contents are deployed or unpacked to the runtime environment. We will open this deployment definition to see how it has been defined. Select the build engine from the overview tab of the deployment definition. The build engine must be running on the system that the package is being deployed to. The package definition determines which artifacts will be deployed. The load method determines how the output objects will be moved from the build system to the deployment system. The properties listed here are determined by which load method you selected above. This is the directory where the package will be deployed. This is the directory where the package was created. In the Restore Mapping table on the Deploy tab, list the original PDSs that were packaged and the corresponding PDS locations where they will be deployed. On the Publish tab, specify the publishing options. Next, we will request a deployment. By default, the last package created is selected to be loaded and deployed. Use the Builds view to monitor the progress of the deployment request. The Deployment Summary tab shows all the output objects that have been deployed. The Summary Work item lists details about the deployed objects. The Links tab lists the links to the artifacts associated with the deployment, including the deployment result. The outputs listed on the Downloads tab are determined by which options were selected in the deployment definition. To see details about deployed packages, from the context menu on the deployment definition, select Query Deployed Packages. In a similar example, we will load the previous package based on a work item and deploy it. The Deployment Summary tab shows all the output objects that have been deployed and the associated work items. This time, we will do a rollback deployment. A rollback changes the output objects back to the previously deployed. Click the Rollback Summary tab to see the results. This concludes the demo. For more information and demos, please click on one of the following links.